Hello everyone, my name is Andy and welcome back to CapTech, and today we're going to be taking a look at the Yodamaster D35 Pro external hard drive case. Now, full disclosure, the company did send this to me for free to review for you guys, but they're not getting to see the review before you will, and they have no input on what I say. This is just my honest, unbiased opinion. Now, I will put a link to the product in the video description down below where I got this from Amazon, so if you want to go check it out, you can. In the meantime, let's see what you get in the box when you order it. So you get the hard drive case, of course, the stand with non-slip grip feet on the bottom of it to keep it from moving around, the USB cable, the silicon shock absorbers, the power adapter, four adapters to go along with that, this tiny screwdriver, a small bag of case screws, and the manual too. The case itself is made of an aluminum alloy. It's nice and solid, and the one thing I like about it is the way it's polished, just like a sandblasted polish, is it doesn't leave fingerprints on it. So if you're going to have this sitting on your desk, it's not going to end up being an eyesore after you've been maneuvering it around and you get your clammy fingers all over it. It's still going to have a nice clear shine on it. It's not showing up any fingerprints, and I really do like that. You can see on the front side and on the back side, it's got this what they call a meteor design to it. It allows ventilation for air to go in and out, and it really does help a lot with the heat dissipation. Now, the case itself only weighs just barely over a pound, as long as there's no hard drive in it. Of course, if you put a hard drive in it, it weighs a little bit more, but the case itself only weighs a pound. It's hollow inside, and it's very thin. Design's like 1/32nd of an inch wide, so it doesn't take up a lot of weight. If you wanted to throw this in your laptop bag or something, take it with you on the road, it's really not that heavy at all.
So now I'll show you how to go ahead and put a hard drive inside this. Use the included screwdriver to remove the two screws from the back plate where the connection cables actually go into, and this will allow you to get the tray to slide out where you put the hard drive in. If you want to use the silicone shock absorbers, this is where you would want to make sure they're on the drive now before you ever try and put it inside the case. Place the hard drive inside the chassis and slide it forward into the connector so that it is nice and flush all the way up against it. Use the four included screws to tighten the hard drive into the case to keep it nice and secure and keep it from bouncing around. And then you would slide the drive bay back inside the chassis until it is completely all the way in. Replace the back plate all the way back onto it. It only goes on one way. And then replace the screws that you took out earlier, and you are pretty much good to go. Now, this isn't the simplest of tasks here. This is something that takes a little bit of time, so it's not the kind of enclosure that you would be swapping out hard drives all the time for. This is more one of those where you would put the hard drive in that you're going to leave for a while, put this on your desk, and use it for doing backups, or if you just want to use this as an external media. They do make different versions of this same case that you can find on Amazon, and they can actually set it up with a RAID array, so you can have multiple hard drives in there. The one I'm using here is just a single drive, so that's pretty much all there is to it, just the one drive, and you are done. The rear of the drive bay is where you would plug the power cable into. The little black button is the power on and off button, and the USB 3 cable connection slot there. This drive bay will support up to 10 terabyte size hard drives too, and it is backwards compatible with USB 2 in case you have a little bit of an older system.
Now, the little silicone covers that comes with it just snap onto the ends of your hard drive, and one side of them's got the holes cut out so it'll line up with the SATA connector and the power part. And this is basically just for shock mount within the case. You don't have to use it if you want to. You can have it hard mounted to the case and it should do just fine. This just adds a little bit of extra protection while it's in there. If you have a standard style mechanical drive, they vibrate when they're running long periods of time. It can get a little bit of a wobble, of course. If you have an SSD, it's not going to matter. You don't have to have this on there, but it is nice they actually included it, and it just kind of slides on. And these are silicones, so they conduct the heat really well. So if your hard drive's getting really hot, these aren't going to melt or cause it to get any hotter than it normally would. Now, the case does come with its own tiny little screwdriver here, but if you look real close, you'll see that it's a six-pointed star-style screwdriver. It's not a Phillips or flathead. And so if you lose this, you're going to have to try and find another screwdriver like this around your house or at a hardware store or whatever to be able to take these teeny tiny screws out. The screws that come with it are the flush mount, the screws that match up just like this. But if you have any standard hard drive screws that are Phillips or flathead or whatever kind you want, they fit in the same case. It's just a standard hard drive case screw, but it comes with this teeny tiny little screwdriver here. So it's nice that they included this and it has its own style screws to go with it. But again, if you lose this, then you're going to be a little bit hard pressed unless you have some of these already laying around the house. So just something to keep in mind. Not really a negative as much as anything else, just because you can replace the screws with a standard Phillips screws that you would put in a regular hard drive casing. This is just kind of one of those heads up in case you get it and you're wondering where the screwdriver went, or if something happens to the screws themselves, you can just replace them with regular screws too. Now, the included cables they give you are about the same length. Power cable is just a little bit longer than the USB cable, but both of them are only about 3 feet long, roughly, about a meter long, so they're not very long. So if you're going to have this sitting right next to your desk, wherever your computer is, or your laptop, or your Mac, or whatever it is, you need to make sure that you have a way to be able to plug this in, because it's not very long and won't stretch very far. That's not atypical with devices, though, so it's not a downgrade on the review of this product. Just letting you know ahead of time that if you're going to try and put this, and it's going to be a little ways away from your computer, you may want to try and get a little bit longer cable, or at least if it's just for the power cable, you can get an extension cord. It should work just fine, too. Now, one thing that is nice about this particular product is it does come with several different adapters for different places you might want to use it around the world. So, got the standard adapter you'd use here in the U.S., just snaps into place, and there are four other ones if you want to use them varying different countries that have different style plugs there. Got a little button you push here and give it a little twist, and it pops off really easily. The contacts inside are pretty well placed with inside of it, so they're not going to get bent or scraped. Now, on this side, they stick out a little bit, but they're nice and sturdy, so if you accidentally leave this unprotected and lay something on, it's not going to bend the prongs here. All right, then. Well, that concludes my review of the Yodamaster external hard drive case. This is a really well-made product. I actually do enjoy using it. I do recommend it, and hopefully this will answer some of your questions, if you're on the fence about getting it or not. If you have any questions, of course, you can leave it in the comment section down below, and I'll see if I can help you out. If you found the video useful, maybe do me a favor and hit that thumbs up button down below, and think about subscribing if you're not already so you don't miss out on future reviews and tech-related videos. So thank you guys so much for all your time. You have a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later.